I kind of get kind of nervous. There's a lot of people in the crowd, you know. People say, like, it helps if you picture the crowd in their underwear. But there are a lot of really fucking ugly people in here tonight, so I do not think I'm going to do that. But as you can see, not the most athletic guy out there. Kind of rough. It was rough growing up. My friends always wanted to play basketball. And of course, I'd get picked last, and my team would lose, and they'd be like, Peter, you fucking suck. And I'd be like, you know what, man? I don't even like basketball, okay? If I liked it, I would be good. If I liked it, I would practice. But I'm not gonna practice because I don't like it, you know? But when you're younger, it's like, okay, I make excuses for things. But now I'm an adult. I'm 19. Like, I need to start owning up to my shit, you know? But like, I still do the same things. Because my girlfriend last night, we were in sex, and she turned to me and she's like, Peter, what the fuck are you doing? I was like, hey, okay, I don't even like sex, okay? If I liked it, I would be good, okay? If I liked it, I would practice. But I'm not gonna practice because I don't like it. No, my girlfriend's pretty cool, though. She just, like, sometimes she thinks she's really funny. She's kind of annoying. Like, I'll be eating my cereal. She'll walk in the room and be like, Peter, you're a cereal killer. She's so funny. God rest her soul. As you can see, like, I'm kind of tan, which is alright. Sometimes I'm like really tan, I know it's weird. In those moments, people will mistake me for Mexican, which normally, like, I don't have a big deal with, but recently a lot of people have been kind of racist towards the Mexicans, you know what I mean? I felt some of the racism firsthand. I was out shopping at Safeway, and this big old white guy came up to me and pushed me. He was like, hey, you, go back to Food City. And, like, it honestly really hurt my feelings, but I went to Food City and I got some great fucking deals. So, you can get 1,000 tortillas for 99 cents. What are you doing at Safeway in the first place? God. I have crazy parents. You guys got crazy parents? Yeah, great, wonderful. When I was 10, I walked in on my parents having sex. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude. I was like 10, and I was like, I don't know what that was, but it looked good. That's all I can say. My mom was like, Peter, it's not a big deal. We're just wrestling, okay? We're just wrestling. And I knew, I was like, Mom, that was not wrestling. So I decided to, like, mess with her a little bit. Next day, we were out shopping, I just saw this random lady and I waved at her.
Go ahead. There you go.
She was like, Peter, who's that? I was like, oh, that's the lady your dad wrestles with when you're not home. Got her. And then I got really good with this one too. I came back from my uncle's house. And my mom was like, how was Uncle Rex? So that was pretty cool. Just like, kept trying to wrestle me in his closet. I'm just kidding, guys, I didn't wrestle my uncle. Like, we fucked. Like, by the time I was 11, I was good at fucking, you know what I mean? I knew where all the holes were. And then I had sex with a girl, and I was like, what? Plot twist, new hole, wow. That's pretty cool. I haven't gone back since. I was like, I am sticking with this hole, I like it. No more jokes, guys. It's time to get serious. A couple months ago, my brother had a drug overdose. Yeah. It was really hard on the whole family, especially my mom, though. My mom was just, like, destroyed by it. I remember she came up to me at the funeral. She was like, Peter, I want this dealer dead. I was like, Mom, why would you want two dead sons? She did it through, lady. I don't know. I think, like, there's certain situations we hold in our lives that we all can relate to. Like, this happens to me, like, I think every night. Like, I'll wake up in the night, go to the kitchen, get a drink, and then, like, now I gotta walk back from the kitchen to the bedroom, and as soon as I turn off that kitchen light, my brain tells me that the fucking Pennywise from It is right behind me, right? So now you gotta, like, walk back to your room as fast as you can. Faster than a dream was Jorge, and he saw an immigration customs truck drive by. In your room, slam the door, and like every single night, I don't know what you guys are in my bedroom for, instantly turns into fucking Legoland, and everything I step on is just like sharp as shit. Get in your room, climb in your bed. Like, I don't know what you guys, I do this to this day. Like, I'm 19 and I'm still doing this shit. Got hide under my covers because I think, like, if Pennywise is gonna walk in, he's just gonna be like, where the fuck did he go? Or, like, how funny would it be, you think, if you walked in and was like, dude, you suck at hiding. I'd be like, you know what, man? I don't even like to hide, okay? If I liked it, I would be good. If I liked it, I would practice. But I'm not gonna practice because I don't like it, you know? So I'm gonna end with this guys right here. You guys like horoscopes? Yeah? I love horoscopes. I think they're pretty awesome. I'm gonna read a couple people's horoscopes, if you guys don't mind. What's your sign, man? Bro, okay, it says, you tell it like it is. Yeah, there you go, I can tell by that, that's true. I don't even know what that means, honestly. What about you, man? Okay, it says, you overly sacrifice for others. Yeah, I don't think that one's true, but I don't know. Ooh, let me find somebody. What about you right there, man? Yeah, what's your sign? Capricorn. Okay, it says, you're a bitch! She's like, yeah, yeah, you nailed it. Hey guys, my name's Peter Fowler, everybody. Have a good night.
Alright, this next comedian comes to say, I just met her backstage, she's hilarious, she is obsessed with the UFC.